Hey guys, Addis, how to the Bastards International. Today I will show you how I measure inrush current. Inrush current is very important. It's the thing that trips your electrical circuits in the home once you try to turn on the PSU, especially if you have this PSU turned off for quite a long time. I'm using a picoscope probe which utilizes a Rogowski coil. Now, Rogowski coil technology has a couple of advantages over CT, current transformer technology. For me, the major advantage is that there are no magnetic elements in here. They do not have magnetic materials, so EMI disturbance is very low. I have tried many different ways to measure inrush current, and believe me, it is very, very tough to get accurate readings. But with this thing, I believe that problem solved. We have all this stuff here only to measure inrush current. Yeah, exactly. And now we can do it with only this, and of course a picoscope. Differential scope, which is not affordable, definitely, but it does a very good job.
Wait, so, I have a question.
Yeah.
So you can either use these.
Yeah, one of these. Yeah, one of these and the top or that.
You will have the same results.
Yeah.
And what's
no, I don't have the same results. Okay. I believe that this is way more accurate.
And what's the price difference? I mean, is this cheaper?
The power analyzer that we have in the Greek lab costs about 12,000 euros alone.
Okay.
And the device above that costs about 500 euros.
You mean this one?
Yeah. It connects to the power analyzer and it is controlled through the power analyzer. This is a very, this is a good device actually. It allows you to open the PSU. You can select at which angle of the AC input you will start the PSU. So it gives you lots of options. But the thing is, that is also susceptible to EMI. And you can see lots of noise, especially from the PSU's switch. I have some readings, 200 amps, 160 amps, which I don't believe that they are real. So I wanted something that gives me a graph, something to show.
Because this doesn't give
you a graph? It is very difficult to have a graph on this, and it is not as high definition as here. So I wanted a high definition graph. You know, this is something that when any engineer argues about that, hey man, this is not the correct reading, you throw him the graph, he says, okay, yeah, you got me here. So let's see how this.
Yeah, but you didn't tell me the price difference between that small.
This is 400 euros.
What?
Including shipping.
What?
Yeah. Yeah. But you also have to buy the oscilloscope, which goes about 1200 euros.
Okay.
It's
okay.
About the whole thing.
Yeah, but it's a lot cheaper than these two.
Yeah. 1600 euros against about 30,000 euros. Yeah, it's a lot of cheaper. So we have a fast auto, an ancient loader, but it still does a very good job in what we needed to do. I only use it to completely drain the bulk ups of this unit. So let's start
wait,
here.
Wait, people is gonna ask.
This is the Vertex, yeah, Seasonic Vertex.
So when are we gonna see it? I mean,
it is already public in the Cybernetics database.
Okay.
The reports, they can go there and see it.
And how about buying options?
I believe in somewhere into next month. I'm not sure. Something like that.
Okay.
Yeah, Seasonic Vertex 8X version 3. And no, this video is not sponsored by Seasonic. I just had this PSU on the test bench, so I thought, hey, I will use that. I have the fast auto connected. The PSU is currently off. If you want to show this, the power switch is off.
Mm-hmm.
So we have no readings here. And I have set up a trigger. The trigger, 10 amps. I have set up already the picoscope up for the probe, 200 amps. Here is the probe. The probe is set at 300 amps maximum. It can go to 3000 amps, but yeah, this is insane. And let's give it a go. Nothing. It is very difficult to completely drain a cup. It's not that easy. And this is why many labs get wrong in RAS current readings. The input is 230 volt AC right now. I have the AC source over there for 115 volt or whatever input I want to use. I do this now manually. I can do it automatically by using this device. This device allows me to open the PSU to provide the AC input in the PSU in any angle I want. Usually about 90 to 180 degrees, the angle of the AC input is the worst case scenario. But for me, it's much easier to take multiple readings by using the power switch. Yep. Here we have an in-RAS current reading. Here it is. You see that?
Mm-hmm.
This is clearly an in-RAS current reading. 61.16 amps. That is not high at all, especially for a high capacity PSU like this one. Although remember, it doesn't matter the PSU's capacity, but the capacity of the bulk caps. But typically, high capacity PSU's also have large bulk caps.
When you say capacity, how many watts?
I think this is the, yeah, the 1200. This is the 1200. Yeah. Okay, let's do it again. Are you ready?
I'm ready, but I'm not sure about the PSU.
Nah.
Told you.
Who said that it's easy? No, it's not that soon. Because I drained the 5 VSB. I have also a loaded at 5 VSB. And this is the easiest way to drain a bulk cap, to apply a load to 5 VSB, because 5 VSB is constantly on.
I have another way to drain it.
No, don't say that.
Okay.
Don't say that. Yeah. Only 13.31 amps, yeah, that's nothing.
You're disappointed.
Mm-hmm. I will apply a higher load here. You didn't ask me what brands usually do to restrict in-RAS currents. Manufacturers, factories, PSU designers.
What do they do?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Install NDC thermistors, one or two of them, which have some resistance. So once the cap, the bulk cap, asks for lots of amps, the resistance sets the limit. It says, hey, you can go up here, no more. So you restrict the in-RAS current.
The NDC thermistors do that.
The NDC thermistor.
Right.
And there's also a bypass relay, because the NDC thermistor is useless once the PSU starts, because the bulk capacitor is okay. But if you leave it in the circuit, you have energy losses on it. So they use a bypass relay to put it out, isolate it.
It's very scientific.
Mm-hmm. Okay. That's good, yeah. You have a very nice, clear reading of in-RAS current. And here is the value.
So do the companies know how much is the in-RAS current of their...
Of course, of course. If the manufacturer or the factory that made the PSU doesn't know, then something is way wrong. And this PSU actually has a low in-RAS current, especially for 230 volt. The rule is not always, but in most cases, the in-RAS currents are higher as voltage increases. So at 230 volt, we have higher in-RAS currents compared to 115 volt input. This is not always the case. And remember, what matters the most is the capacity of the bulk capacitors and the value, the ohms value, the resistance of the NTC thermistor.
Is it possible to find a PSU without NTC thermistors?
Yes, some old PSUs used plain resistors, which are energy hungry. Because the thing with the NTC thermistor is that once it gets hot, its resistance drops.
Yeah, of course.
And it does that because if you don't have a relay, you don't want to have an NTC thermistor draining all the energy of the incoming signal. As the PSU operates, the NTC thermistor's value goes, the temperature goes up, so resistance drops. And it's like a short circuit, so it doesn't affect the efficiency. It doesn't affect so much. But there's another problem there. If I do that, PSU drains, okay? And again, if the NTC thermistor is hot, so very low resistance, it doesn't protect the PSU because it doesn't set the limit. It doesn't have the resistance. It doesn't have enough resistance to limit. The relay is there. The relay is there to isolate it and leave it, give it time to cool down, and be effective. To be effective in a case of a hot restart. Bypass relays are usually used in higher efficiency PSUs. From gold and upwards. In bronze PSUs, it's very difficult to find a bypass relay protecting, isolating the NTC thermistor. I believe I said enough on this. If you have any questions, leave it on the comment section, Discord server. Please subscribe to our channel. Thumbs up for the video if you liked it. If you didn't like it, okay, again, thumbs up. I don't have a problem with that. We have a Discord server. You can contact us directly there. And that's all. Bye-bye. The thing is that is also susceptible, possibly.